Waging War on Corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
We are now into hour number two. And if you just joined us, we have Congressman Ron Paul scheduled to be joining us in the middle of the next hour. We have Colonel Craig Roberts joining us coming up in 30 minutes. We'll go over a host of important news and information and get his perspective on things. But this is just such incredible news. Speaking of radiation, cancer surges in body scanner operators. TSA launches cover-up. The union, according to Watson's article, and he's got links to some others, reports that they've had big increases in cancer, one of the first airports many years ago to test the scanners out, and that there are charging there's been a cover-up. Also, coming to a store near you, radioactive fish, that's up on Infowars.com. Also, they're reporting all over the news that Fukushima is continuing to dump massive amounts of radiation into the Pacific Ocean. And it's now been confirmed that part of the nuclear power plant has been flooded here in the United States, in Nebraska. And there's a headline, what the Fukushima is going on in Omaha. That's from local talk news. With the history of government cover-ups, we don't know what the truth is. We know that there was a disaster right around a few days after Fukushima started months and months ago up in an area of Canada, and they released a bunch of radioactive waste into the lake and said, don't worry about it. And radiation levels have gone up, and the media has been told by the government, hey, we're just raising what we say is safe. You know, being shot in the head with 357 Magnum would probably kill you, at least hurt you. But if the government just said, hey, 357 Magnum rounds fired into your head at point-blank range no longer hurt you, would that suspend the laws of physics and nature? No, they wouldn't do that. Now, I meant to come into the show today and get into this incredible report. And again, there are thousands of studies all over the world going back 80, 90 years dealing with plastics. And that they are oils. They're oil-based, and many of the drugs that Big Pharma has made are petrochemical-based because they can manipulate it. And that the bisphenol A that's been adopted in most plastics, the liners of tin cans, plastic juice boxes, you know, all of it, even the paper ones have that lining. It's how the paper doesn't get soggy, doesn't break through. Normal paper box would, that it leaches estrogen mimickers, and it also causes endocrine disruptions, overall disruptions, and we covered that report. And of course, literally hundreds of these. If you just type in hermaphrodite frogs, hermaphrodite fish, sterile frogs, I've seen studies with upwards of half of them in the southern Mississippi now being sterile or having both sexes. And it's also changing the brains of the frogs. Now, the globalists would spin this as a human right. The frogs have a right for us to dump this in the water and make them hermaphrodites or make them confused. See, it's a scientific issue, but they would say, you're being a hermaphrodite frogophobe. And I'm like, what does this have to do with people's sexual preference? I'm saying they're choosing it for you, and that it's not like a preference. They have biologically altered who you are, and that's been the plan all along. And we cover it in the in-game extras, the university documents where they talked about doing this. And now we got Holder and all the others. This is what they've done. And they're keeping it in the plastics. They're keeping it in everything. They're doing it. They don't care. And they're not going to stop. You have to stop eating and drinking out of what they're doing. And then you've got the GMO crops. Every major GMO crop in every major, even internal study, has the, quote, side effect. It's the real effect. It's the perfect place to hide it in that genome that's so complex that only the genetic engineers who were inducted into this Malthusian eugenic school at the major universities, and then if they buy into it, they get the grants, they get the jobs, they then know what they're doing. Of course, they're all obsessed with organic food because they know what they're doing to everybody else. It's a cult. Hi, folks. This is Alex Jones. I'm looking for people that have the wisdom to spot savings, opportunity, and recognize risk. Saving means to make money. The Calbin Pure Soap Company can save you thousands of dollars and give you good old-fashioned real soaps that are triple concentrated and twice as good as what you're using now. Soaps made from vegetable and coconut oils that contain no useless dyes, perfumes, deodorants, or antibacterials. Your risk is the hundreds of hazardous toxic detergents that give you rashes, itching sores, and deteriorating clothing called lint. If you want something better, if you want something you've never had before, you have to do something you've never done before. Getting a free catalog is easy by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calbin on the web at 5starsoap.com. Take charge of your health now by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calbin on the web at 5starsoap.com. This is Alex Jones with five good reasons you should consider buying a solar power generator. Number one, new climate legislation could easily double or triple your electric bill. Number two, our new energy czar wants to control how much power your electric company allows you to have. It's true. Total government control of electricity in the name of smart grid technology is coming. Number three, in some areas of the country, the power grid is dangerously overloaded. And now new socialist legislation is only compounding the problem. Number four, dangerous weather is always a threat to local grids. Every year, thousands of families lose their power from weather-related outages. Number five, a solar power generator provides powerful backup insurance and peace of mind. Folks, I really believe in the solar power generators offered by Solutions from Science, one of my oldest sponsors. You can get more information at www.mysolarbackup.com. That's mysolarbackup.com. Remember, the government doesn't own the sun, so go to mysolarbackup.com or call 1-877-327-0365.
The folks at eFoods Direct have saved you from the huge price increases on food by buying raw materials ahead and packing your supplies themselves. They haven't increased their prices on great long-term food reserves since last year. With the rising cost of raw materials and gas prices, they can't hold off any longer. As of July 1st, eFoods Direct is forced to increase their prices so they can still ship you the best storable food on the planet. Until the end of June, you can lock in the cost of your food at last year's prices by calling 800-409-5633. Your time is running out to build your supply with the best food on the planet at last year's prices with eFoods Direct. Call 800-409-5633. Prices go up at the end of June. Go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. Call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex.
He's the T-Rex of political talk. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
I want to commend everyone that marched into the Capitol for the second time in a month yesterday in Texas to try to ensure that a true bill to defend the Fourth Amendment, to defend the Tenth Amendment, to defend our dignity of our women and children would be passed. And they gutted it seven ways to Sunday. I'm going to be breaking that down. But resistance is victory. We've been talking to the reporters on the ground. It looks like now even the Senate and House version won't be able to be merged. So it'll probably die, but if it goes into special session, we've got to continue to analyze this bill and probably try to kill it. But we're going to break that down, if not today, tomorrow. But and I haven't decided yet if I'm going to go back down there today. So much is coming in fast and furious. If you just joined us, breaking cancer surges in body scanner operations, TSA launches cover-up. And television in D.C. Is reporting on this. And the head of EPIC, the Electronic with Privacy Information Center, great folks, Mark Rottenberg, I think we've interviewed him. They've talked to the unions and others. And it's been going on for years there at Boston and other airports where the TSA has been testing since late 2002, the scanners, huge cancer clusters. And they use all the other private studies and even university studies have said it's deadly. They've misrepresented John Hopkins, and the head of the study went public last year and said, my study said it'll cause cancer. You misrepresented in the news saying I was for this. It's the same thing with NIST. NIST will, Well, NIST has changed its story on Building 7 falling at free fall and how it fell five times now. Now they say they don't know why Building 7 fell on 9/11. So it's a very disreputable, corrupt government-funded agency. I mean, what do you expect? NIST has agreed with the UN that the sun doesn't affect climate, and they're backing carbon taxes with fake science. Of course, the sun drives climate. It's the main driver. Anyone who says otherwise is completely insane, according to all the top meteorologists we've interviewed. But your common sense, ladies and gentlemen, knows that it affects and drives the climate. We would be absolute zero in a matter of days if the sun disappeared. I mean, it's just asinine. And the sun's fluctuations, like the heat on a fire, when you're frying eggs, when the sun fluctuates up and down and the heat it's putting off. I can't believe I'm even having to explain this. You know that, okay? So they put out this report that they wouldn't give Congress last year. Finally, it's coming. They wouldn't give Congress this. The numbers are blacked out. And they're saying, yeah, there's some radiation leaking out of these. But we say it's healthy for you. But then they black out what the radiation level is. And so it is on. The fact that they've covered up the cancer clusters. And this report is up at Infowars.com. This could break their back. The fact that it's not just travelers going through the porno scans that store an image of your body, or that they're frisking you with dirty gloves that they don't change but every 100 or so searches, that it violates the Fourth Amendment, trains kids to be molested. It's the equivalent of walking down a dark alley, in the worst area of New York or Chicago or Houston every time you go to the airport. You don't know what's going to happen to you. Untrained people on power trips told to do this stuff. They themselves, victims of their own tyranny, they're being roasted by the machines, as I've kept explaining. We're going to get more on as well, the scientists. We've interviewed the radiologists. But, I mean, again, my dad's a dentist. They have a radiation officer who wears a badge. They're checking it monthly. Companies have to come in and calibrate it and check it and do readings. But the federal government just says we're exempt from our own laws. They don't even have a regulation that does that. And they don't want to give Congress the numbers. So here is a TV newscast dealing with it. In fact, if you'll just put the video paused up there on screen, I can give folks the call letters of the TV station. Thank you. In fact, I even have the printout here. Yes, WUSA 9, and I've got those reports printed. I just can't find them in my stack. But we'll go ahead and play that news clip here as a public service warning, especially to the TSA people. Here it is.
There are new questions this evening about the safety of those body scanners being used at the nation's airport.
Yeah, questions like, do they expose TSA workers and passengers to unsafe levels of radiation? In tonight's top story, Gary Nuremberg is here with what is now an uncertain answer. Gary?
Well, uncertain, Derek, because some prominent scientists say there just isn't enough data, hasn't been enough testing to demonstrably prove the machines are safe. The government says the scanners are safe, but documents secured by the Freedom of Information Act have raised questions.
We think that the Department of Homeland Security has not been forthcoming with the public about the true extent of radiation risk with the airport body scanners.
He points to a National Institute of Standards and Technology memo,
saying that the Department of Homeland Security had overstated that agency's support for the program.
The union representing TSA workers wants dosimeters to measure the radiation workers are exposed to, but that has been denied. In Boston, a union memo cites a growing number of workers diagnosed with cancer.
We certainly feel that the program should be suspended pending an independent investigation.
In a letter to the president's science advisor, university professors agreed, saying safety tests of the machines were performed by the manufacturer and questioned the science of the safety studies. They conclude important information has not been provided to the public, saying there is still no rigorous, hard data for the safety of X-ray airport scanners. Dr. John Sadat telling 9 News Now, we do not know what the dose is. The dose can be a lot higher than they say it is. If you go through, you're taking your chances, he says. TSA issued a statement saying it has implemented stringent safety protocols to ensure that technology used at airports to screen people and property is safe for all passengers as well as the TSA workforce. Each individual machine that uses X-ray technology is regularly tested to ensure the radiation emitted falls within the national
safety. They got caught lying last year about that.
Despite those assurances, those scientists and Rotenberg from the Electronic Privacy Information Center want independent tests of the machine.